We're holding in the Hakdama by Yom Moshe, page Yud, the right column at the bottom. Vihine. Vihine ro'isi. And this is now going to the subject of why people have been so taken in by Zionism. And why is it? Is it all lahachis? It's an aveira people want to do on purpose? Or is it because they're just ignorant? So look what he says. Vihine ro'isi ki shoyer shatois animshech bozeh bo'olam. The root of the mistake of why people are fooled into believing in Zionism is Hasiba Rishoni. The first reason is he lefish shelo yardu leumkam shel dvarim, that they didn't go into the depth of things. They didn't study the sugi well enough. The bir halachazu shel shal shvus. They didn't study the inyan of the shal shvus well enough. So people just mach the vek. They say, okay, it's not negay, whatever. The nations, the UN, whatever. They don't realize that there's the whole sugi here, and they didn't learn it up well enough. They don't realize how deep things go. How terrible the Isser is and how serious it is to take a government before the time of the Gula. And that's why they didn't conquer their taiva and their desire to be like the nations of the world and to have their own country. Like you see, Amratzah people always write, Jewish self-determination. Why don't the Jews have a right to self-determination like any other people in the world? So if these are Orthodox people saying this, obviously they didn't learn the Torah well
enough. Say the same,
and they don't understand what the Torah says about Zionism.
Well, people also say
the Shuv, Matzu, and after that, once they've missed the point and they don't understand that there's an Isser here, then they realize that they say, okay, we want to be part of the state, but okay, it's a secular state, we don't like the fact that it's secular. So then, okay, Shuv, Matzu, Gam, Amas, Lois, then they find excuses with Yishabri, Moim, to join up with them. And say, okay, we're going to make them more from. We're going to join the state. We're going to make sure that the laws of the state are, you know, they keep Shabbos in the army, have to eat kosher.
Yeah.
El Al shouldn't fly in Shabbos, things like that. Af shehem aminim v'koyfim mesisim medichim. Even though they don't, the Zionim themselves are secularists and they're trying to make everybody join them. But v'koyfim, these parties think shekein haya b'mei Achav v'nasha. They think that Zionim are no worse than the time of Achav. And Menashe, who did avoid the Zara, and they had avoid the Zara, but they had a right to be king.
Well,
they had
a right to have a kingdom. Tens of millions times worse.
But here, the difference is they don't have a right to even have a government and a state to begin with.
Yeah, Achav and Menashe were kosher kings. Api Halacha.
Right, they were
still had kosher kings.
Just that they were Meisim Mediach people to do avoid the Zara.
After how they became king, and they went off the derech, so to speak.
Right, the Chas v'Shalom Hutra Harutzua, and therefore. It's become almost like hefker, there's no rules anymore. And they join this government. And that's what you see with the Aguda, that originally what the Aguda did was they joined the government, but they didn't take ministerial portfolios, they didn't want to become officially in the government. And then for a while they took a minister without portfolio, and now they have Litzman, who is a minister like anybody else.
And he's legalizing pot. You heard about that?
What'd you say?
He's legalizing pot, okay, marijuana. That's big news.
Okay.
Every time he's legalizing marijuana. So he's under pressure. He's not for it, but he's just under pressure.
The chol zeh mi pituyei ayetzer. This all comes from the convincing of the Yetzer Hara, who gets us to go little by little into the aveir. He starts out with one thing. He says, don't learn the Shal Shvua Sugya. Next thing he says, okay, I have a limud schus on the Medina. Next thing he's telling you, join it. And next thing he's telling you, become the leader of it. So, v'shani minus de mashcha. And minus is different because it draws people in, it attracts people. K'moishis bar b'fnim, as I'll explain in the Sefer. And that's the Gemara, in the Avodah Zarah, Daf Chof Zayin. It says that that once there was a Tana whose name was Ben Dama, the nephew of Rabbi Shmuel, who got bitten by a snake. And there was an early Christian heretic there named Yaakov Ish Kfar Sechanya. And he knew how to heal snake bites. So he said, I'll heal you. So Rabbi Shmuel, his uncle, said, no, you can't heal him. So Ben Dama said, I have a proof that it's mutter. And he was about to say it, but he died before he had a chance to say it.
What was he going
to
say?
Doesn't say. So the Gemara says, but we'll bring a raya from Rabbi Shmuel that he did not let this doctor Yaakov heal him, that we don't allow a non-Jewish doctor to treat a Jewish patient, even if the patient is going to die, because We're afraid the doctor's going to kill him earlier, and that's what the Gemara in Avodah Zarah is about, really, that you can't go to a non-Jewish doctor because the doctor is chashur on Shefichas Damim, so that even if you're sick, you know, and you're going to die anyway, don't go to a non-Jewish doctor.
You're making him do an aveira.
No, because you'll die earlier. Let's say you were going to die in a year.
See.
You go to the non-Jewish doctor, you could die right now.
It only applies in the case where the guy was not afraid of the government.
Right.
Not in our day where the guy was afraid of the government.
It's different.
Yeah.
In any case, but the Gemara says it's not a raya from Rabbi Yishmael because Shani Minish Damashka. That the reason why he didn't let this doctor heal him is not because he was afraid he was going to kill him. He was afraid that he would actually end up healing him and people would be influenced by it. He'll say, let's say, the name of his Avodah Zarah while he's healing him, and then people would say it must be the Avodah Zarah.
He was Jewish, of course, right?
I think so, yeah. Yaakov, his name was Yaakov.
Yeah, so obviously
Yaakov
he was Jewish, by
the way, the Gemara doesn't say anything about Yashka and the Christians there. It just says Yaakov Ish Kvar Sechanya, but in the non-censored Gemara it says, to me Talmidei Yeshua Noitzri. So that's how I know. So a lot of times the Rebbe is going to use the words Shani Minas Demashcha in the Sefer, and the reason is because he's trying to say that Minas is more chomer than Avodah Zarah. Avodah Zarah, it says sometimes you're allowed to run to a base of Avodah Zarah to save your life, but not a base Minas. And that's in Siman Pei Zion, he's going to say that if you can't join up with an organization of missionaries, then Kol Shekein you shouldn't join the Medina, Shani Minas Demashcha. And interestingly enough, in Maamar Yishev Be'eretz Yisrael, you know, there's a famous statement in the Gemara that says that La'olam yadur adam be'eretz Yisrael afilu be'ir sheruba nachrim v'al yadur b'chutz la'aretz afilu be'ir sheruba Yisrael. You should prefer to live in a city of Eretz Yisrael, even if most of the people are goyim, rather than living in chutz la'aretz, even if most of the people are Jews.
Yeah.
So the Zionists bring that down. They say, look how important living in Eretz Yisrael is. But the Rebbe says in Siman Lamed Gimel of Maamar Yishev Be'eretz Yisrael, that's only Nachrim, not Apikorsim. Apikorsim is worse than Nachrim. Mm-hmm.